Hello fellow tankers, in this video I will address the Carina map and give you some sacre bleu, enough of that shit. Guys, the experiment is still ongoing. What is the experiment? Well, you know, in November 2013, the mad scientist in Gagin have decided to introduce the ground forces in their game. I mean, it's really an absolutely brilliant idea, there's no mistake about that. And they created the first map, Karelia, and they have also started their devilish experiment. What is the experiment? The experiment is happening here, look. The mad scientists at Gagin have decided to look at what would happen if they would put two spawns pretty close to each other, separate them by a ridge, and also allow for a very straightforward access to one spawn to the other. And for the last almost 7 years, the experiment is going on. And what are the guinea pigs doing? Well, essentially, they are camping over there, or camping over there. It's not even camping, I mean, seriously, they are shooting to each other from maybe 50 meters away, while some other players are charging the enemy spawn. In the same time, a few crazy guys, you know, are actually fighting in the western part of the map, you know, where you have, oh, look, you have actually three caps, and you even have two spawns, okay, so you can actually go there. And, but, I mean, these guys are kind of crazy, you know, I mean, capping, fighting for caps, I mean, that's so crazy. And sacre bleu, the experiment is still going on. So, who are the guinea pigs? For me, they are two categories of guinea pigs, and to understand that, you know, I'm a kind of mad scientist myself, so to understand who are these guinea pigs, you have to ask, why are they going there? So maybe you can ask yourself, if you are going there on this map, why are you going there? I think that the majority of people going there are going there because people are going there. Yeah, people are going there because people are going there. If you think that it's absurd, it's actually happening on several other maps, like Korea, you know, why people are camping over the dam on sea, because there are people camping on the other side, essentially. Why people go to the castle in Fulda, well, because a lot of people are going to the the castle in Fulda, and why people are going to the city in Tunisia, I think it's mostly the same reason. So obviously you will find a lot of let's say not very good players, to say the least, which hopefully will improve by watching some of my videos, but you will also, curiously and interestingly enough, find good players, and sometimes even very good players, very good players in the sense that they are very very good killers. That doesn't mean that they have a developed strategic knowledge of the maps, but essentially their aim is to rack a lot of kills, and since they are very good killers, well, in most maps they actually succeed in doing that. I mean, sometimes they win, sometimes they lose, but essentially they don't care. Well, it's not my notion of the game, but I kind of understand them, and they go to this spawn because that's where you find the French, sacre bleu, what am I saying? Fresh guinea pig meat, and they charge the enemy spawn with their powerful tiger or jumbo and essentially eradicate the guinea pigs in their spawn. So essentially, people go there because people go there, or people go there because they want to kill the many people who go there, which is almost the same reason, but if you think about it, it's not completely Exactly the same reason. So let's just look, have a look at these two spawns. You know, oh look, even the even the bot is spawning there. Or maybe it's not that surprising. So you see, it's beautiful. You have these two roads, the fast access to one spawn to the other. And this ridge separated by something like what 50 meters, and boom, 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 the guinea pigs are shooting. Well, let me finish my rant by telling you that at the end of this video, so really keep watching, I will give you a huge secret. Okay, and this secret has nothing to do with War Thunder, so be patient, don't skip to the end of the video. Sacre bleu, please listen to me, don't skip, and I will reveal to you capital information, believe me. So now let's stop this rant, let's be a bit serious, and let's talk about the actual strategic tips on this map. Okay, so let's start again. Hello fellow tankers, in this video I will give you some strategic tips on the Karelia map, and then we'll present you gameplay. So the Karelia map, the Domination Karelia map, is a triangular map in the sense that each side have a cap which belongs naturally to them, and there is a third cap which is quite isolated and which is not in between the two natural caps of each site. So that means that in the beginning of the game, people will have to decide whether they want to push toward the enemy cap or to concentrate on the more isolated cap B. So initially, I think that you understood that I advise you to actually spawn on the west. Actually, even if you spawn on the east side, especially from the red side, it's very easy to avoid the guinea pigs participating in the experiment by going this way. This way, for instance, and attacking B from the other side. It's a bit more tricky from the green side, because if you have already people attacking the green spawn here, you will meet them here. But if they are not still there, it's very easy actually to avoid the campers here by going this way and coming up to B from here. So, as I mentioned, this map is triangular, and in a sense is a bit similar to Advance to the Rhine or Jungle. And again, you essentially have two options: to put pressure on the enemy cap or concentrate on B. My advice is that actually B really plays a very important role on this map, because once the area here is controlled, and if you have enough gun depression, it's very easy to shoot over essentially the entire area here, even at the spawns. I won't advise you to do that, because the people in the spawn have a good cover, but why not? You can help pinning people in the spawn. But my advice is that you clean this area while being aware that some new people could come from air or from sea. So what's the best access to B from the west side? So you should go, if you want to cap A, my advice is that you go this way and not this way, where sometimes you can be actually sniped in the very beginning of the game. So you go this way, and then you go straight to B, by this little road here. My advice is really that you don't go through this road from both sides to go to B. You are very exposed, and the slope here is quite abrupt, and you will be essentially pinned on the top of this road. So go this way if you are coming from the green side. If you are coming to the red side, the same. Don't advance too much on C if you want to cap C, for the same reason, you may be sniped. And if you decide simply not to stop to C, which often I don't, well, you can come down here and climb to B from here, which is again better than climbing from here. Obviously, when you are on B, so you should, and that B is controlled, you should be concentrating at cleaning the lower grounds, but also, I mean, being sure that the enemy is not climbing again from B, and of course, you should cover also the people for the people coming from the eastern spawn. That can happen, and essentially you have to be very careful of people popping from the street if you are on B. My advice if you are on B, go around here where you are protected from people coming from here, essentially by people coming from here, and you can concentrate on people coming from here. And if you are on the green side, people coming from here, hopefully if you are not alone on B, you can, I mean, your allies can cover different angles that you would not be able to completely cover together. So so again, B is really the most important cap, but as on all triangular map, another option is to put pressure on the enemy cap. And so you have a very different route. For instance, you can go completely at the west of the map, which will allow you to put pressure on the exit of the two spawns. If you do that, I mean, probably you are not really concentrating on the cap. You are indeed more concentrating on sniping imprudent players exiting from their spawn. But anyway, that can be effective. It's not really my style. Strangely enough, you will discover that the best covered access to the other cap is actually following the main road here. You will see that following the main road here, you cannot be sniped from the spawn, and you have actually a very good cover for any tanks which would be in this area. And of course, but like everywhere on the map, you have to be a bit careful at the people from the hill, especially if the enemy team is controlling the hills. So very often it's actually almost a straightforward drive to the enemy cap, just exactly following the main road. Try it. If you don't believe me, you will see it's very surprising. I could not believe it myself when I tried it long ago. That's actually the best way to attack the enemy cap. And definitely, honestly, the middle area here is simply bad. As I mentioned before, the western access is can be interesting, but essentially, again, the aim would be to shoot at people exiting the enemy spawn. But Let me also mention that from me, of course, you can, let's say that if you come from the red side and if you have control B, you can actually attack A by taking exactly the opposite path as the green tanks, that is going down here and attacking B from there, and the same from the green side, which is a bit more tricky because when you are in this area, you can actually be seen from the red side. Let me add that in realistic battles, if you are here or just at the exit of the green spawn, you have a hill here which provides a pretty impressive view over the entire map, and if you have a tank with good gun depression, you can have actually a very good sniping spot. If there is a sniper there, you have really the red team should really tell their allies to bomb or rocket the any people camping from there with a powerful tank. In RB, I also like in this area here there are some trees, and this area overlooking the sea cap is pretty well covered, and a green tank can sneak and shoot at people exiting the spawn or around sea. Of course, again, if you see someone in RB which is at a very dangerous spot, mark him on the map, and hopefully this person will be eliminated. The same for the red side. If you are, there is a spot in this area which is pretty interesting in RB again. But after you have killed one, two, or three guys from here, my advice is that really you move, because you will have been spotted if the enemy team is not completely stupid. So let me recapitulate on this map. You have here the experiment, ongoing experiments for the last 7 years almost. And here the three caps, the three triangular caps, which allow you to essentially control B, which should be still your priority, but also to put pressure on the opposite cap. And my advice is that you actually essentially follow the main road, even if the western access here is also interesting. Let me just comment on the two conquest maps where the only cap are either C or either A. In both maps, which are honestly not very, very interesting, let me just advise you to really control the top of the map here, the hills, where B is usually. If the only cap is A, you can shoot at green tanks coming to A. You can shoot at red tanks coming to A, and of course you should forbid the enemy to access to this area. If C is the only cap in the conquest map, then again you can shoot at C. You can shoot at red tanks coming at sea, or you can shoot at green tanks coming at sea. And again, you should really concentrate in controlling the hill. Usually, very often, let's say the team which controls the hill win the conquest map. All right. So I have decided to show you a replay on one of the conquest configuration of Karelia, but you will see that this configuration share the same feature as the more classical triangular configuration. And this feature is that this hill is extremely important, and essentially you cannot cap or keep the only cap if you don't control this hill. So I'm playing my Italian 6.3 lineup. I am playing with two squad mates playing their 6-7 lineup. And we are in a 7-7 game, so I'm not very so happy to have chosen this lineup. So I'm taking my M36, which was a very mediocre tank, but which recently received a new ETFS, so it's a bit less mediocre. This 6.3 lineup for me is the first fun Italian lineup. In lower BR they are not so bad, but they are not that good. You have a few interesting vehicles like the Breda, but especially the tank destroyer line is honestly very boring. You have five or six vehicles which are essentially the same, with a gameplay which is not very interesting. So here it seems that our enemy, who was present on the hill for sure, a bit oblivious of the fact that they have also an enemy, and I'm killing this M48. I was a bit lucky because when I killed the first tank, I actually broke in the same time the gun of this M48. And I realized that, and so I charged him right after, and I'm starting my sniping, my camping. So yes, no camping is camping, but it's active camping again. I'm not camping shooting at other campers. I am camping shooting at active players, enemy players, fighting for the cap. So again, remember, if you want to know if your camping is useless or useful, it's very simple. If you are camping shooting at other campers, you are useless. If you are shooting at active players, you are useful. The idea that if you are shooting at campers, we can remove the two sets of campers from the game and nothing changes in the battle. So that means that they are useless. And so after a good start, unfortunately I get killed by this Nashorn. Maybe I was a bit too cocky. And so this 6.3 lineup with the Fiat, the AUBL, which has a terrible ETFS, the M36 which I featured previously, and the American M26 is pretty okay, but really the Italian lineup starts to be good at 7780 with the Santoro, the OF40 and the M47 for instance. But really, it really shines at high BR and especially in top BR with the automat and the free varieties. You have one of the best lineups in top BR. So you see that there is still a big struggle on the hill. We momentarily got the hill, which allows our team to cap A, but the enemy is back, and unfortunately I will be damaged by a plane, so I will have to repair. It's a bit ironic that the Italians have already three varieties, whereas they only produce 200 of them. Whereas us poor French, we are still waiting for a second Leclerc, but probably coming soon. We mentioned that there was at least 12 batches of Leclerc into an SNG4 series. And finally, here the gun handling of this tank is not very good. It wobbles a lot. The suspension of the tank is not very good. I'm a bit too slow. Actually, I was essentially killed by the 50 cal. But maybe that was not very well played. So I'm coming back with my M26. Which is a pretty good tank when you are top BR. But unfortunately, as soon as you are not top BR, even Tiger 2H are really hard to pen. You have only 170mm penetration. And even if you have a bit of armor, for a medium tank, let's say, this tank is really not to play a 7-7 game. But let's go back to the hill, and now it seems really to be controlled by our team. So again, don't forget that at the end of this video, I will reveal a big secret, so don't skip. So I plan to go back to this position, but after checking, I cannot see really anything to shoot at. So I decide to go back. And I actually notice that several red tanks are now coming to the hills, but from behind. Yeah, I kind of made a mistake. I should have killed the M46, and I shifted a bit clumsily to the Tiger, which is a bit lost in this 7-7 game. I should have really shot the most dangerous tank, the M46. Here you see the limitation of the gun of the M46, which could not pen the M103 on the side. And now I realize that we have two other tanks coming from the other side of the hill, so I'm going to check. And I kill the first one. I'm going for the second one, but he will be killed by one of our allies. And so I go back to the hill. And I'm shooting at this Ori production, which should be tough to penetrate, and indeed I don't penetrate it, but look, my artillery kills it almost at the same moment. So I was really saying that, thinking that this game was really going very well for me. Unfortunately, I was probably a bit too cocky and got killed by an ice. So obviously, you can imagine that we won this game. So 9 kills, 3 assists, playing a 6.3 lineup in 7-7. That's pretty good, pretty good, and also a bit pretty lucky, I have to say. This lineup is an okay lineup, but it's really not an OP lineup at all. You note that my squad mate Arium had also a very good game with essentially stocked tank, at least some of them. Very, very good lineup. Well, sorry, not that good lineup, Swedish lineup, but an okay lineup, which I am also playing. Arium is actually from Sweden. He had an excellent game. Again, remember it was, as you can see, we saw M103. It was, and here T54 was a 7-7 game. So I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and my rant about the experiment. And now I think it's time to reveal the secret, Sacre Bleu. Well, the secret is that French people never say Sacre Bleu. Sacre Bleu is a very old-fashioned exclamation. It's only used in American movies where you have Americans with fake French accent again using Sacre Bleu, but Sacre Bleu has not been used by a French guy for the last let's say 90 years except for me in this video. Let me just tell you that it literally means holy blue, which means absolutely nothing, but it's actually a modification of sacré dieu, which means holy god. But since it was improper to use the name of god, it was changed in the Middle Age into sacre bleu, which was perfectly acceptable. So if you want really to act like a French, never say Sacre Bleu. Honestly, did you ever heard me say hum, hum, hum? So don't say hon hon hon. But maybe in other videos I can teach you typical stuff that French people say. So thank you for watching this video and see you in battle. À bientôt sur le champ de bataille.